Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. In this video, I'm going to break down for you how to earn money with data annotation jobs online. I'm going to explain to you in detail what data annotation jobs are in theory, how they work in practice, and how you can earn money with them even as a complete beginner with zero coding skills whatsoever. So with that being said, drop a like, let us get started right away. Alright guys, so for this technique I want you to head over to fiverr.com and to select AI services as a job category here in the top right corner, and on the next page to scroll down to this section named data and to select data labeling as well as annotation jobs. And you can already guess it, data annotation jobs are jobs that are related to working with the artificial intelligence, so a typical AI job. Just in case this is the first time you're dealing with data annotation in general, let me outline in just a few words what data annotation actually means and how you can earn money with these jobs. As a freelancer, for example, here on Fiverr, it is in fact pretty simple and no rocket science at all. You don't have to train any language models for this, you don't need to have any advanced coding skills whatsoever to pull this off, guys. And yet, as you can see, guys, it is possible and doable to earn quite decent amounts of money with data annotation jobs here on Fiverr. If we scroll down this list of available gigs in the data annotation niche, we will notice that freelance data annotators here on the marketplace of Fiverr are charging actually quite decent sums for the data annotation services to clients, ranging from $5, which is the minimum amount you can charge as a freelancer on Fiverr, over $10 and $20, even up to $100 or more for data annotation services. So to get a better insight, let us take a closer look at this example gig here, titled "I will do bounding box polygon image annotation for AI." So it is in fact pretty simple. As a data annotator, it will be your task to label items like, for example, objects in images, in videos, on audio tapes or audio files, and even in 3D or 2D animations. For example, by marking these objects or by drawing circles and squares around them, and by classifying them by leaving annotations next to them. Like for instance on this image here, we see high traffic on a road, a series of cars driving down that road. In that specific case here, the annotator has been given a task to mark and to draw boxes around cars, as you can see, or around vehicles in general, and to classify them by assigning different colors to them, like for example red for sedans or smaller cars, blue for SUVs and trucks, and so on and so forth. Sometimes a data annotator may get asked to draw boxes around the given object, sometimes to draw exact shapes. Like on this example image here, cars in yellow, cyclists in pink or violet, and other objects like street lamps, as it seems, in green. And this freelancer here, for instance, charges $5 for drawing 400 of these bounding boxes around objects on images, $25 for 2000 boxes, and the most expensive package includes 4000 of these bounding boxes for a price of $50. So that's, for example, how image or video annotation jobs work. Super simple and mind-blowingly beginner-friendly, I'd say. You absolutely don't need any special skills or advanced knowledge for that type of jobs. All you need for that is an eye for detail, some basic computer skills, and also some persistency and patience, because I assume drawing boxes around thousands, over thousands of objects on these images and in videos might exhaust you if you do this for hours all day long. But at least you don't need any special qualifications or certifications to do this. It's not only classifying objects on images and in videos and drawing boxes and circles around them though. Data annotation includes jobs and tasks that deal in general with collecting data for the AI. And that data can be collected, for example, through transcription jobs too, through audio annotation jobs. Let us take a closer look at these, for instance. So what does an audio annotator do for a living? Well, he listens to audio files or audio tapes and classifies the audio with suitable tags and labels according to this definition here. Sounds pretty complicated, so let me put it in simple words. So as an audio annotator, you listen to an audio file and simply and label and classify what is being said on tape, for example by person A or person B, and leave an annotation here to the right next to the corresponding timestamp. For example, person A is speaking in a calm voice. from the 31st to the 37th second of the audio file. Person B replies to person A also in a calm voice from second 41 to second 48, for example, and so on and so forth. So for that type of job, for audio annotation jobs, you need some good listening skills and some proper comprehension and knowledge of English, which leads us to the next important question: how much can you expect to earn, for example, for that type of audio annotation job? Well, this online platform here that has been designed for freelancers, AudioB, offers a payment rate of $7.20 per every audio hour you successfully annotate. Not per hour you work, guys, but per audio hour you listen to and annotate. So don't confuse these two. So is this a profitable job, a lucrative deal? Well, you gotta decide for yourself, guys. It depends pretty much on how fast and how accurately you work. If you're a good listener and have some advanced English skills, well, then you might be able to complete these jobs pretty fast. However, since these data annotation jobs can be considered pretty low effort jobs that don't require any special skills and any prior expertise, I'd say you don't expect too much from them. They will most likely not make you insanely wealthy. It also depends, at least to some extent, on how much you charge per data annotation gig, for example here on Fiverr, on how well you market and showcase your skills and services here on the marketplace of Fiverr. That's why it is important and so relevant to always deliver quality work and to use eye-catchy expressive thumbnails for your gigs to get your clients' attention and to make them choose you or hire you instead of your competitor. Speaking of the competition, guys, let me tell you why I personally believe data annotation jobs and in general any jobs that are related to AI training have some real potential and can definitely be considered potential jobs of the future. Currently, for example, guys, you will find only 760 services under the search term or category data annotation here on the marketplace of Fiverr, which means there's still a lot of space for your own gigs to establish them on the marketplace. As you probably know, AI technologies are just on the rise and gaining popularity day by day, which means jobs that are related to AI training and collecting data through the AI are going to gain pretty much popularity in the near future too. I mean, more and more companies and brands are implementing and using AI services and systems for their businesses. And as you probably know, AI needs a lot of data to work properly. That's what these AI training and data annotation / data labeling jobs have been designed for, to collect masses of valuable data for the artificial intelligence and for various AI services and systems through the aforementioned jobs, like, for example, annotating images, videos, audio files, transcription jobs, and so on and so forth. It's like data entry for the AI industry. So these companies and brands are going to look for more and more data annotators and data collectors and labelers to collect these masses of data for their AI services and systems. And even though this is still a pretty underrated niche with not even 1,000 services ongoing here on Fiverr, there is already some decent demand for that type of job. Judging by the amount of sales and customer reviews, some of these data annotation jobs and gigs we see listed here have already received. Like that one here, for example, with 61 customer reviews so far, that one next to it with 22. So as you can see, there is already demand and clients are already purchasing or ordering that type of services. At the end of the day, I believe it's just a question of how fast you take action and of how well you market your services as a freelance data annotator on marketplaces such as Fiverr. Of course, Fiverr is not the only online platform or marketplace that allows you to sell your data annotator or AI training services. Luckily, there are a couple of websites, apps, and online platforms that offer that type of services too, like, for example, Little Loca app. Then we got Remote Tasks. These guys focus on annotating images, videos, and even 3D animations. And lastly, also the OneForma application, guys. So I'd say you take action as fast as you can, guys, if you're genuinely interested in earning money as a data annotator, because as previously mentioned, that industry, that job category has a huge potential. At least that's my two cents on this. And the sooner you take action, the easier you will have it to establish your own gigs as a data annotator / AI training specialist on these sites and marketplaces, guys. So I'd say, to not make this video too long, we call it a day here. If you enjoyed this tutorial video, make sure you hit the like button and I'll see you guys next time.